Now, some of the sanctuaries will tell you that there is a surplus of chimpanzees and that they shouldn't be allowed to breed. And these are the same people who are setting themselves up as the guardians of chimpanzees, as those who are going to speak for them. They're rounding them up from wherever they happen to be found in the United States. And they're sending them to these places, which are glorified concentration camps, where the chimpanzees may live a full life, perhaps, but they're not allowed to reproduce. And when they're gone, their genetic material, their heritage, everything that normally we expect to pass on to the next generation will die with them. The Jane Goodall Institute will tell you that this is for the good of chimpanzees. The chimpanzees belong in the wild, and that any place where they are found where they're not allowed to live their wild existence, they should not be allowed to breed. And I disagree. So, well, I don't know what's going to happen to Beau after I'm no longer available to care for him. What I would like to think that I will be able to do for him in the long run is to place him somewhere where he will have a full life and be allowed to reproduce and be involved in the raising of the young and for there to be a future for his descendants and the descendants of other chimpanzees. This is very important to me. Now, in the wild, various apes, including gorillas, have a hard time surviving, and one way to fight for them is to use guns. I'm a very big fan of Dian Fossey's. I think that if you are going to go and do that, you are going to have to fight as if you are in a battle where you're fighting over land, because that's what we're talking about. We're talking about occupying the same ecological niche. The great apes, and specifically chimpanzees, are the same kind of animal that we are. That's why we can't coexist. You know, you can have rabbits and human beings living in the same area, and as long as it's not too urban, then the rabbits and the humans can coexist. But chimpanzees and humans occupy the same ecological niche. They're fighting for the same land. It's not possible for everybody to win unless we learn to go coexist. Now, human beings are known for the fact that they've been successful and they've eradicated anybody else who was similar and who occupied that niche. This is a book that I would recommend for you to read while you're thinking about this. If you think that it is possible for chimpanzees to be somehow conserved in their native habitat in Africa, think about all the other contenders, all of our other relatives, close relatives that we eradicated. This particular book will tell you about 22 species of extinct humans. Well, whether we want to call them humans or not, there are certainly 22 species of extinct great apes from our close-knit family. That's what we do to those who compete with us in the same ecological niche. The future for chimpanzees is to live with humans. Because when we domesticate an animal, then that animal gets to survive. How many wolves are there in the world? How many dogs? How many buffalo? How many cows? The future for chimpanzees is to coexist with humans. And that's what I want for Bo and his children and his grandchildren.